Here is how to get powerful backlinks to your website 100% legally. Using these link building techniques, my websites are getting over 6,000 page views every single day. And here is exactly how you can get those powerful backlinks as well. So let's go and build those links. Backlinks are still extremely important in 2022. And in this study published on backlinko.com, you can see that the number of domains that link to your website is still the number one ranking factor that determines whether pages on your website actually show up in Google search or not. And one of the best ways to build more backlinks to your website that I have personally found and used is through outreach. I'm going to show you the exact outreach methods that I've personally used, including templates, which you can implement right away after watching this video. Step one of the process is to create a list of prospects. For that, you need to create a list of sites that are topically relevant to yours. For example, if you've got a gardening website and you would like to grow your authority, you need to get some links that are from related websites about either gardening or home care or something that is topically related. So to get started, type in anything into the search bar on Google that is a relevant search for your website, such as how to start a tomato from seed. From there, you would need to review each of the organic search results and work your way down through the top 10, 20, 50, or even the top 100 results and input them all into a template. You can start a simple template like this. I just call it Outreach Prospects. Here, we're going to note down website, contact page, email, and any notes that we would like to add. Each of these websites that are coming up here in Google search are excellent prospects for us, because if we somehow manage to get a link from any of these articles to any of the articles on our site, which is also about gardening, it is a topically relevant link and it will help us boost our authority in Google's eyes so that our site can get higher rankings too. So let's take a look at this first potential prospect. Let's open this up and assess the general look and feel of the website. The big criteria is that this website should not be a corporate website. Corporate websites will generally not link back to you. What you're looking for is a mom and dad type blog or a blog that is run by a small group of real people where you can see their faces and can understand that this is not a huge corporate blog with a ton of money behind it. So let's take a look here and let's see what their content looks like. From what I'm seeing here, this potentially could be a suitable blog. It's a good idea to look at the About section, and we can now see that there are real people behind this blog. It seems like there is a large group of people, it's about 10, so they may or may not be willing to link to us. But still, this is not a multi-billion dollar corporation that is running this website, so potentially they may be willing to work with us. So I would add this website into our shortlist of prospects. So let's just add that in here. Then I generally like to also take a note of their contact page so we can see it over here and see if I can figure out an email on which I can contact them. In general, websites these days don't really publish emails, but from time to time you do see them. So here we can say email NA. We just need to contact these guys through the contact page. Okay, and if there are any notes that I want to put down, I can do that in here as well. So I can say something like 10 people on the team. Okay, at this stage, that's all you need to do. Just continue creating this list of prospects. Let's take a look at a few other ones. So we can look at gardeners.com. All right, now gardeners.com looks a little bit differently. It looks like it's a corporate website of some sort because they've got something that says garden centers. Okay, so it looks like they actually have outlets. So I think this is some kind of a retail store website, because you can see their order status, customer service, and I would say that this is quite unlikely that this website would be willing to even talk to us. You know, as most of you guys and me, we are considered to be small bloggers, so most likely this website would not be willing to actually work with us. So you can just work your way down, and let's open up the next one, gardenerspath.com. And let's take a look at how their website looks. And is this a mom and dad sort of style blog? So this straight away appears differently. I don't believe that this is some kind of a billion dollar corporation. They earn a commission, so they're affiliate marketers as well. If we take a look here at the bottom where it says about us, so you can see again, this is kind of like a personal website. It's founded by Michael Quinn in 2014, etc., etc. So they may be willing to speak with us. and I would add this website to our shortlist. Once again, we want to grab their contact form. So let's go to contact us over here, Control C, Control V. Do we have an email for this website? Maybe, maybe not. No, I don't believe there is an email, which is fine. And let's just make a note here. I'm just gonna note down person runs this website. So continue working through this in exactly the same way. So you want to pull out the contacts who seem like they're run by real people rather than by large corporations. You want to get about 100 prospects. If for whatever reason you've run out, you can just type in a different search query that is related to your blog. For example, something like how to grow mangoes, that'll give you other hundreds and hundreds of website results to work through. Step two is to reach out to these prospects that you have collected and offer to write a guest post for them. Here is the exact template that I have used with a lot of success contacting website owners and getting a really, really high response rate. The reason why that template works so well is because everyone wants free content and you're really positioning yourself as an expert. You're providing a choice of amazing keywords with low keyword difficulty, and who can say no to that offer, right? So go ahead and go through your list of prospects and either contact them via the contact page or via email if you manage to find the email for any of them. So to do that, just obviously click on the contact page, then open this up and fill out all the information here, insert your message and customize it as much as you can. If you can get the names of the website owners, that is always a lot better than just saying hi or, you know, hello, dear sir. So for that, I would actually also recommend for you, for each of them, to go and read about the names, who is responsible, who is the owner or who is the editor, and then write actually talking to that person. The key is to make sure that you present 3 or 4 keyword choices with full research, keyword difficulty, search volume, and just position yourself as an expert and show that you know what you're talking about. Step number 3 in the link building process is to subscribe to my channel. Seriously, go ahead and subscribe to my channel just below. This way, you will never miss my future tutorials on link building, blogging, and affiliate marketing. So go ahead, smash the like button and subscribe to this channel just below. Step 4 is to get replies and to negotiate the details of exactly what kind of contribution you're going to make. You can expect about a 3 to 5% response rate. You can see some examples over here of the responses that I have been receiving. A lot of people do agree to publish a guest post if they see that it comes from a person who knows their stuff, who knows blogging, and who knows keyword research. Your goal will be to publish a high quality guest post, generally over 2,000 words, and somewhere within the guide, within this article that you publish on the prospect's website, you will be allowed to place a do follow link back to a relevant article on your own blog. So once you hear back from the website, make sure that you go through their site and take a look at how they structure their content and what kind of content you should be creating to make sure that it fits in with the other content that they've published. The last step is to create that content and send it back to the owner of the website. You can, of course, write the content yourself, or you can use a service such as this, Upwork.com. If you type in blog writer, you should be able to find a lot of choices for blog writers and content creators at various budgets from various locations. Once you return your content to the owner of the website, just make sure that they eventually publish. Sometimes people get busy, so you may need to just follow them up every so often to see how they're tracking. Once they publish that article on their site, you've got yourself a backlink. And can you rank any articles on your site without any backlinks at all? The answer to that is yes, but you need to choose keywords with extremely low competition, where the competition is very, very close to zero. And that's exactly what I show in my free course, which you can access. If you click the link just in the description below, you will learn how to find keywords where you can rank without any competition at all. For the more competitive keywords, you do need backlinks. So go ahead and watch this video over here next. This video is going to show you another way, a very powerful way to get even more backlinks to your website fast. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Greg Kononenko, the Caffeinated Blogger. I'll see you in the next video.